I think the real kicker is that like AI, especially like ChatGPT, is too confident. Like it's just gonna tell you something that t sounds plausible. It doesn't know if it's right or wrong. It's just gonna like tell you, and it's like, oh, like the AI looks at patterns and says, this is what sounds right. I don't know if it's right. Here, take it.
That's a very valid point. Wow, good thought. Hey everyone, welcome to the Select All podcast. We're on episode 13, which is amazing. We are gonna try to get you guys content every week, and hopefully you guys stick around and kind of give us some feedback as to what you guys like and what we should present. This week, we have a short episode. As you see, we only have two of us. There's Ali and Taran are out for a couple weeks. And yeah, we just have me, myself, the coding nerd, co-wonder, and we have Mo, who's the grumpy engineer, right? He likes to
What up?
steer people that when they have bad code, right? And really steers them down. And so we're gonna try a little bit something a little bit different this week. We're gonna have one product that we're gonna present, and then we're gonna have one what's hot topic today, and see what you guys think about that. So yeah, Mo, why don't we kick it off with the first one, the first product breakdown?
We have, for those of you that are trying to secure yourselves and have like OTP on all your devices, now you can use WhatsApp as your OTP device. This is a very bare bones site, obviously, but it's a tool to allow you to log in via a WhatsApp message, which I think is interesting, mainly because like a lot of parts of the world use WhatsApp over text, and I'm sure it's a way to drive conversations through WhatsApp rather than the website. And I'm sure there are business cases out there that would really appreciate this.
Yeah, I was wondering about this. It's like when you mentioned it, does it, I don't think it helps with kind of integrating with WhatsApp, does it? It's more of you can log into their website with WhatsApp, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Yeah, no, that like you mentioned, I think that's a very interesting it opens up interesting case. It opens up a huge market right off the bat. Right, there's people in, I don't know, like India that probably they probably do have Gmail, but there might be places where they don't actually have Gmail or Facebook or things like that, even though that is widely used. But WhatsApp, I feel like, is used even more
Yeah,
across the board,
no,
right?
100%. WhatsApp is used like when I went on my honeymoon to like Portugal, like a lot of the business there have WhatsApp numbers. I know a lot of like side hustles in Toronto, like they utilize WhatsApp to like conversate with their clients and just make connections. I can see this being used to be like trying to onboard someone, like, oh, here, let me give you a couple options, and then you give them the link via the WhatsApp, and then it like since you've already set up whatever their account is on your website, like just giving them this link and then having authenticate through WhatsApp, it just I think it would be a seamless experience for the client.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. And is it officially run from WhatsApp, like the company, or is it
I don't
an
think so.
external party?
I'm pretty sure this is an external party. Like
Okay.
their website is very bare bones. I'm sure this is still in like their beta testing phase.
Right.
Like you
Okay.
can look at their
Yeah.
documentation. It's not that much.
Yeah.
But yeah.
That's interesting because it's like, why? What's their benefit to providing this? Do they become the gateway keepers of this OTP process? By the way, OTP stands for one-time password. I knew the process behind it, but I didn't have to Google what it actually stood for. Like I understood what OTP was, but I was like, what does it stand for? But that's interesting because it's like, what do they gain? What do you think they gain from this, a product like this?
I don't know, maybe like their page doesn't link to anything. It's done by OTP less. Let's see if that comes up with anything. Not sure. Maybe they have other product, like their only product is this WhatsApp login. Maybe in the future they're hoping to like get more customer, like users, and sell them other WhatsApp integrations possibly. But
right
as it stands, this is it.
Right. And also they could probably do a tiered model, right? The moment you have like 5,000 users using OTP, then you got to pay a certain amount, etc., right?
Unfortunately, they said free forever for unlimited users.
Oh, well.
So that's a strong statement.
It is, but I don't know. Companies change, you know? They backtrack all the time. So it's like,
I'm sure we'll see. If it gets popular, they're like, okay, you know what? We'll charge like a dollar.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, dollar a month or a dollar a year. Like, come on. They'll make something up. There's too much traffic that's happening. We need support for our servers, etc. Yeah. Even donations sometimes work. Like, you know that Buy Me a Coffee app? I've heard some good things about that. It's like people can kind of fund their projects at least to a somewhat of a minimum to get past that, right? All right, cool. So that was an interesting case. I think I definitely would be willing to try it out with some of my projects to see how it would work. It'd be interesting. We have what's hot today. It's interesting case that we talked about a bit before in this podcast. There is a AI lawyer or AI chatbot that was going to be used. It's called DoNotPay. Was the kind of company that was creating this. And they were going to be scheduled to appear in court via glasses, and it was going to record the courtroom and then be able to provide answers to the person to kind of say out loud and fight the ticket, right, based on the input that it's gotten from the courtroom. And
excuse me,
the reason they weren't allowed to do it actually was that a bunch of lawyers from all over the place, all states, just basically mashed them with insane amounts of threats of "we're gonna sue you," and those had been coming in from before. And they finally got a few that were saying there's gonna be criminal charges. So there was prison time involved at this point. And I don't know if that's possible, and things along those lines. But they were scared enough that they did not even try to mess with them. So they backed out, and I think they're just going to regroup and see what happens. But yeah, what do you think about that? Like, Mo, do you think it should have gone ahead, or do you think the lawyers were just a bit too hasty there?
I mean, I'm not a lawyer. This is not legal advice, but I'm saying those lawyers are smart. Like, they know if this is proven true. I mean, I'm sure there actually is probably a legitimate reason, hopefully, that they block this. Like, maybe they think, oh, this is not gonna be the best interest of clients ever, or like all of our clients. Like, it's just gonna mislead users that are gonna think they can fight cases and then they'll start losing. But the cynical side of me thinks like they're doing this, they're squashing it right now so that it doesn't gain any traction.
Yeah, and they're seeing the thing on the wall.
Yeah, and if that's the case, it's just only a matter of time until someone just brings a phone with them to the courtroom and then just starts using an app to tell them what to say during the proceedings. But
yeah, I think that there'd be another form of this. That's right. That's a good point. Like using it in a different way or a different interface rather than video. The article had mentioned that they were citing the fact that you couldn't record in a courtroom. Right. That's against the law, apparently, unless it's specifically allowed by the judge. So if you weren't allowed to record, and in certain states, I don't even think it's allowed. That's so, why
technically you have the court writer, right? Like the person that types out the. But yeah,
video is different, right? Like, you're not going to be able to edit on the fly. Yeah. Well, maybe later on, but right now you can't edit on the fly. Whereas the court reporter can be like, oh, scratch that or whatever. I don't know what the official term is, but so they're able to do that. Excuse me. So I get it. Like, I think they're going to still try to pursue it in different ways. But I do think it's like the writing on the wall, so to speak. Lawyers are like, all right,
yeah,
this is happening. The fact that there's hundreds of lawyers sending requests to this, it's like they didn't even, it wasn't even their courtroom in their jurisdiction, and they were just sending it in. So it's like, you kind of see why they're doing it, right?
Definitely. I'm sure their next move will be something like, we're not going to be in the actual courtroom, but this is a general outline of what you should do to defend yourself against this parking ticket.
Yeah. And I was hearing about it in other podcasts. They were saying how it depends on the percentage, right? Is it like 99% accurate? Is it 95% accurate? What are the percentage types do you need, right?
Mm-hmm. Actually, like, there's some cases where you don't even need to, I mean, this is specifically for a parking ticket, but I remember getting a parking ticket, and like, to fight it, I had to send like a picture and like my, I guess, my reasoning for why this is not a legitimate ticket. So like, I didn't even need to be, you could easily use Chat GPT or whatever AI for that too as well, right? Like, and no one's going to know.
Yeah. That's a good point. I think AI is, it's just getting on the cusp right now. Like, I do think it's overblown slightly, right? It's getting to a it's getting to a point where every, I'm like scrolling through Instagram and it's like, ChatGPT used for this, AI used for this, AI is gonna do this. And it's like, it might, but I feel like now we're swinging too far the other way. It's like, yeah, it's gonna do everything. And it's like, maybe not just yet, like, yeah, soon. I really do believe it'll be soon, but it won't be in like next year, right? Like, people are going wild as to how quickly they think this is going to kind of change the world. But yeah,
I think the real kicker is that like AI, especially like ChatGPT, is too confident. Like, it's just going to tell you something that sounds plausible. It doesn't know if it's right or wrong. It's just going to like tell you, and it's like, oh, like the AI looks at patterns and says, this is what sounds right. I don't know if it's right. Here, take it.
That's a very valid point. Wow. Good thought. Because if you think about it, as humans, we'll say, I'm not sure, but I think this is it. Right? Yeah. And we give you kind of disclaimer. Whereas the AI doesn't really have, they might have scripted responses saying, I don't have this in my database and therefore respond like this, right? But I don't think they'll be like, they have certain doubt. I don't, as you said, like, I don't think the AI has doubt.
Not even doubt. It doesn't have reflection. It can't reflect on what it's saying. Like, it's just analyzing a pattern and trying to put like this pattern into a coherent response. It doesn't know if that response makes sense.
It's just, yeah, you're right, it's just patterns, NLP, right? Like, yeah. Really under, yeah, we'll see how all this plays out. It's an interesting time, definitely. People who are in my life that had never, I would like, guys, this AI thing's gonna be pretty big, bigger than you guys think it is, and they're like, Kalinda, we get it, like, it's fine. And now they're all like, ChatGPT is freaking crazy. And I'm like, I know, like, I've been saying this, like, you guys, and now they're like, we want to integrate it as a part of our businesses and things along those lines. And so it'd be interesting to see how that plays out. People in the kind of late, not Luddites, obviously, but people who aren't as into tech are obviously being involved in this, which is pretty interesting.
Yeah, I think, like, I think we're veering from the initial conversation of it, but that's fine. But well, my point was that, what you call, like, at some point, all these AI startups that are just literally API wrappers to ChatGPT, someone's going to get a totally incorrect, like, response, and he's going to follow through, and he's going to realize, like, he's going to sue whatever company. Like, I bet you at that point, he's going to get a human lawyer, not, like,
yeah,
not an AI lawyer.
Honestly, that's actually a very good point. Like, eventually they're gonna be like, fuck this shit. Oh my god,
at the point where an AI can like check itself and like understand it's wrong, is that really AI at that point, or is it like an actual thinking thing?
Well, that's what That's what GAI, general artificial intelligence, is, right? Mm-hmm. Like, once they get there, it's game over, right? Yeah. Like, I think that I don't know, it's a bit scary to think about that,
mm-hmm.
right? And a lot of people, they have varying views on this. I know Naval on like Joe Rogan's podcast said, like, he's like, yeah, not in our lifetime. And I'm like, I don't know, man. Like, they're making some significant progress towards this, and it's kind of scary. So I don't know.
Yeah, what I've read, like, it might be just like an S curve where we're seeing the exponential side, and we don't know when that plateau is going to come, right? Like, there may be some really hard, like, technical restraint, like, kind of stalling progress, right?
That's a very good point. Yep. Yeah. And I think that's where it's going to come out to, right? We're going to get to, I personally think it would be a good world for the next, like, I don't know, let's say 100 years, if we let AI, specific AIs, like very tailored AIs, to do a lot of jobs. And then it would remove the kind of redundant, over structured process that people are doing right now that they're not enjoying, right? That work they're not enjoying. And so it will eventually create newer jobs that are more enjoyable and kind of fun to do, right? And it's going to create a bigger pie, but it'll create less company. It'll create more companies, but less bigger companies, because you'll require less people on each workforce working on a specific topic, right? Should be interesting.
It depends. Like, you can never really tell with these things. I mean, like programming and software and automation was supposed to make less work, and we have more programmers now than ever before. Like,
yeah,
we created more work for ourselves.
Yeah, no, but I think it's a translation of work. So it's like there's more work, but now there's less work on another end of the spectrum, right? And those people worked from not doing those jobs and doing like programming jobs, right? So as I said, like, the pie is not going to get smaller, but there is going to be a translation of jobs, right? Yeah. Before it was factory workers to knowledge workers, right? And knowledge worker now to something else. So
fair.
It'll be interesting to see. Yeah. All right, everyone, thank you. This was a very short podcast. Hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully it's easily consumable. Please leave a comment and tell us what you think. Like and subscribe. We'd really appreciate that. And let us know what you guys think. Thank you, everyone. Take care.